Councilmember Mathieu Eugene celebrated the 49th anniversary of Trinidad and Tobago Independence Day on Tuesday, August 30, 2011, at Brooklyn Borough Hall.
I want to very briefly, I just want to thank each one of you for coming here. My colleagues of elected officials and all the dignitaries and all of you, because this event is a wonderful, wonderful event just because of your participation, just because of your presence, and because of the hard work of all of those who work very hard to make it possible. And you know them already, I'm not going to mention them, but I'm going to mention one person, a good master of ceremony. Let's put our hands together, please, for Samuel Clark. Thank you very much. Again, thank you and congratulations to all the honorees for your well-deserved recognition.
Not only Caribbean music, but also
very complex music from the most respected, worldwide respected, famous musician like Mozart, Vivaldi, Bach. You know, this is a good thing, guys, not only to people from Trinidad, but to all of us from the Caribbean, and we are proud of that. We are all proud of that. And also, this is the place of Calypso. Calypso, good music. You know what I'm thinking about, when I see, I look at the audience, I see we all look alike. Brothers and sisters, honestly, I cannot say that you from Jamaica, I know you from Jamaica because I know you. When you look at people, you cannot know exactly where we came from. We can't. That the reason all the time I say, we are all brothers and sisters. Guess what? About a week ago, I was on the 17th floor in my office talking with my staff, and I felt that my chair was moving. My chair, I said, guys, don't you feel something? He said, no. I said, yeah, your feet, let's go, come on, let's go out. And we went out. But when I went out, it was like a carnival, a flood of people, people of all different backgrounds, the man, the speaker, and I heard also the evacuated Pentagon. And I was thinking, I said, oh my God, we human beings, regardless of our position, regardless of our money, our beauty, we are so little. We don't have no power. Just in one fraction of a second, and when we were together, our brothers and sisters, and the main thing could happen in one single. And that the reason I keep saying every time, my brothers and sisters, we are brothers and sisters, we have the obligation to work together to better the community we are living in, and also to ensure that each one of us will get access to quality healthcare, to job opportunities, and our children, children can have also the right to go to school and to have the peace of American dream. That the reason all of us here, we come to this country to have a peace of this American dream. And that the reason I want to commend and congratulate President Obama for his declaration a few years ago. He said that he asked the Homeland Security to be viewed. A congressman very replied knows that better than I do because he's over there fighting for us. And I want to commend also, she had a public forum about deportation, to fight against deportation, that was something powerful. President Obama said that he wanted the Homeland Security to be viewed. The cases of about 300,000 anyway, brothers and sisters, in the least, being deported. Could you believe that people who have been living in the United States for 20, 25 years, 30 years, have been children and family? They deported and leave the family behind. Anyway, I applaud and commend President Obama for that. And this is a victory for all of us. And I hope and I wish that under the leadership of the Congress of the United States, we can unite and fight to protect our brothers and sisters everywhere. Let me finish, let me conclude to say that because there are so many things I could talk about. So let me tell you, as your city council member, I'm working for all of you. What I love doing, but those who know me, I've been doing that way before I was there. What I've been working on, you know, there's a list, but this is so long. Let me just mention that to you. We city council members, the budget was very difficult, but we were able to protect the cost services to the people of New York. 25 houses were supposed to be closed. We were able to see the 25 houses. Thousands of teachers were supposed to be laid off. We protected. Daycare centers, we protected from being closed, also senior centers. And we were able to stop all services, as I said. But let me tell you, with respect to my district, despite the difficult budget, I am still a strong supporter and advocate for education. Because without education, we cannot do nothing. I was born to give all the school in my district still the art of future labs with smart ball. And thousands, as a matter of fact, thousands, millions of dollars for program for children. Do you know Erasmus? Erasmus High School?
Yeah.
You know, they have a beautiful auditorium. Yeah. When you go to Erasmus for graduation of the children, you see the children pounds, oh my God, it's so hard. Guess what? I was involved to see the funding for Erasmus to get a very brand new air conditioning system. If you go to Church Avenue, when you go to Church Avenue, look up, you will see beautiful antique historic light on Church Avenue from Flatbush to Coney Island. I was part of the funding for this project to beautify our district. And this is for all of us. And also, you know, this not here today, right? You know, Town Center Sudan.
Yeah.
Last year, I was able to give about 1.5 million to Town Center Sudan and 2 million to Kids Fund. That was last year. And this year, I was able to secure $2 million for Town Center Sudan for this year and $2.5 million for Kids Fund. For them to buy state of the art material and supplies to treat cancer. Because that is so important. Let me finish by saying that. You know, our children, our parents, you know, our parents also, they need places to go and relax. The children need places to play. I'm inviting you on Thursday at 8 o'clock at PS 92. On Parkside, on Road and Parkside, and one shop. I need to the city park and location department millions of dollars to create a brand new park and all this for our children. And we are going to have a groundbreaking Thursday at 8 o'clock. You are all invited. This is another way for me to improve the quality of life. My brothers and sisters, it is a good pleasure, privilege, a blessing for me to be able to serve you. And I'm sorry if I spoke too long, but I must tell you that today, remember that when you leave this room, I'm tuning you to the bond. God bless you.
Where things were really, really rough, and we thought that East New York and Brownsville was burning, built our communities. Baranksy not only gave up his talent, his know-how, but almost his life, because many nights, guns were put in our faces when we were trying to make changes. We know about diversity. I think this man is a symbol of that, even though these days it's a very popular word to use. He also made a change in the lives of many, from a career building part, to employment, to immigration, to health, to housing. And many of you, you deserve this. May God continue to bless you.
I repeat.